I'm Paula Storm. Thanks for joining me today on my YouTube channel. First up this week, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about colours. Now this week we're doing the Spinning Star foundation paper pieced block. This is actually my favourite block in the whole quilt, but it is a little bit tricky. So hopefully you've built up your confidence and you're ready to take on this challenge. Okay, now this week we're going to need a total of 8 coloured fabrics. Now instead of using the slow and steady fabrics like I did in my quilt, I've actually decided to use these beautiful K facet fabrics this week to show you, because I think these colours are a bit more true to the rainbow, and I think it'll be a bit easier for you to understand if I use these fabrics. But please go ahead and use whichever fabrics you like. All you need to do is choose out 8 different fabrics and number them from 1 to 8. Now I've started out obviously with red, that's my number 1, orange is number 2, and so on. We've got yellow, green, blue, purple, yellow, green. Okay, so if we take a look at this week's pattern, what I've done is I've given you the template up here, but I've also given you a colour guide down here. Now what I did was I've just numbered all of these triangles with fabric 1, fabric 2, etc., because I didn't want to influence your colours, or if you wanted to change the colours to whatever you choose, then you can manually put in whichever colour that is and allocate it to a number. So for me, I've got fabric 1 out here is the red, then I've got fabric 2 is orange, fabric 3 yellow, and so on all around the outside of the star. Now inside the star, we've got, they're in a different order, they're a bit mixed up, so you're not going to find them all in exactly the right place or where you'd expect them to be, just because of the way this block is. So the first thing we need to do is make up our templates. Now I'm not going to show you that again because we've done that in the last 2 foundation paper pieced videos, so I've already done it, so I'm ready to go with my 2 templates. So there they are. That one actually goes that way. Now what I've done on here is I've marked all my lines, I've pre-folded it as well, and I've also numbered each triangle on here with the number that I've allocated each fabric. So once again, number 1 is red, number 2 is orange, and so on. Okay, so you need to make up your templates. Now you technically only need 1 of this template, even though we're going to be making a total of 4 of that piece. So if you have a look, this is the outside section of the star. So we've got 4 of them that are exactly the same out here. If you want to, you can make up 4 of these. It just makes your piecing go together quickly. But for today, I've just made up 1 of these. So let's get to the cutting. Okay, now for the background fabric, first of all, what we need is we need 4 3.5 inch squares. So these ones obviously are going to go in the outside here. So they're my 3.5 inch squares. We also need 4 5 inch by 3 inch strips, and they're to go on the triangles on the outsides. And then we've got all of our fabrics. Now for the coloured fabrics, we're going to need from each fabric 1 4 inch square. So I'm just going to take my pre-cut ones. So we need a 4-inch square, and we also need a 3-inch by 2-inch strip. And that's all we're going to need for every single fabric. So head on over to the Slow and Steady Quilt Along blog or website and go to the blog page, and you'll find all of the written instructions there. So you'll be able to get the cutting guide from the blog. Oh, and we also need 1 2.5 inch square of our background fabric. That's going to be for the very center of the block. Then all I like to do is I like to lay out all my fabrics in numbered order. So we've got number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I find if I lay them all out in the right order, it just keeps it a bit clearer in my mind about where I'm going and what I'm doing next. So that's what I've done here. Okay, so let's get started. First of all, I'm going to be making these pieces, which are the outside of the star block here. These are the most straightforward, so I recommend you start there. Now, first of all, what we need is we need 1 triangle of our background fabric. So this is this piece here that we cut at 5 inches by 3 inches. So we need 1 of those. We also need, for this first one up here, we need a fabric 3 and a fabric 2. So we need a yellow and an orange. So as I've got these laid out, I need a yellow and an orange. So I'm going to take my big square here and I'm going to take my other big square of the yellow. So I'm going to need those two pieces, I need my background piece, and I need my foundation paper piecing template. Okay, so we've got our three pieces together. Now this is obviously, as I mentioned earlier, for the first piece up here. So we need to take our background fabric and, as always, flip it over to the wrong side because we always iron the freezer paper to the wrong side of the fabric. I'm going to place that on top. Just center it because you want to make sure you've got a full quarter inch seam all around the outside. And then I'm just going to iron that onto the fabric. So you can see the freezer paper stuck to the fabric there. Now all we need to do is fold back that first seam allowance and we need to trim up our quarter inch seam. So I'm going to grab out my add a quarter and once again pop it on top and trim my seam allowance. What you can also do here is, if you want to, is you can trim up that other side as well. I tend to just leave it there for later on. Okay, now let's go back to the pattern page to make sure that we get the right piece on here. Okay, so I like to lay it on top of the pattern piece just to make sure I'm in the right position. And then I fold back my fabric so I can see underneath which colour I need this time. So this time I've marked it as yellow, so we need to use this piece first. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take it to my fabric and lay it on top. Now, as always, I'm going to make sure that when I lay it on top here, there's enough fabric underneath my folded back piece of freezer paper to make sure that it's going to fit out here. So I'm just going to lay that on top. That looks perfect to me, and I'm going to stitch that seam. Okay, so I've sewn that seam right next to the freezer paper. So you can see it's right next to it. I'm not sewing through the paper like traditional foundation paper piecing. Okay, so back at the desk now, what I need to do is I need to trim up that seam allowance. So I'm going to leave it folded, the paper folded back. I'm going to line up my add a quarter and once again trim off that excess fabric. Now, I want you to keep all of these little pieces because you may need them later on. Now I need to fold this back and I need to press my fabric so it lays nice and flat. And also we want it to stick to the freezer paper. So I'm just going to give that an iron from the front side, but then I'm also going to flip it over because you'll notice that it didn't stick to the fabric when I pressed it from the right side. So I need to press it from the wrong side to make sure that that seam or the freezer paper sticks to my fabric. So you can see now that's really nicely stuck. Okay, so there's my first piece. Next thing I need to do is I need to fold this one back. Just peel it away from the fabric if it's stuck there. And what I need to do now is I need to trim up my seam allowance here so it's ready to add my next piece of fabric, which of course is the orange fabric. So I'm going to line up my add a quarter ruler on the seam there and I'm going to trim that off. So there we go, we can get rid of that. That's rubbish. Okay, so now it's time to add in my next piece of fabric. Now what you can do here is you can put it down the bottom here. If you can see through, you won't be able to see it on camera, but I can see a shadow of the orange. If you want to be really conservative with your fabric and if you don't want too much wastage, but I would suggest putting it somewhere in the middle so you make sure you don't run out of fabric. Okay, so I'm going to pop that on like that. And I'm going to take this to the machine. I'm making sure if I fold that back, I'm making sure there's enough of the orange fabric all the way around the outside so it covers this piece of fabric when it's folded back, or this piece of paper when it's folded back. So I'm going to go and sew this seam here and then we're nearly done. Once again, sewing right next to that freezer paper, but definitely not through it. Okay, so let's trim this one up. Once again, I'm just going to put my outer quarter on, line it up with my freezer paper template, and trim that off. Now, once again, I'm going to keep that piece of, or that triangle, because we may need that later on. So I'm just going to put that to one side. Okay, so once again, I'm going to open that up, flip it over, and fold my fabric back. Give it a press from the right side to make sure it's nice and flat. And then I'm going to flip the whole piece over and give it another press from the paper side so that we know it's perfectly stuck down. Okay, and there we go. That's our first piece. If you look at it from the front, we've got a beautiful, looks like a flying geese, doesn't it? Now, when we need to trim this up now. So what we need to do is we need to add a quarter inch all the way around the outside because there's no seam allowance included in this piece yet. So once again, take your outer quarter ruler, line it up with the side of the freezer paper, and just trim off the excess fabric all the way around the outside. Okay, so let's get rid of all that scrap. That can go in the bin. Okay, now here's our finished piece. So that's the first part of the outside of our star. Now you can stop here and go and repeat that process and make another four of those, or you can leave the freezer paper on because the next step of the process is to add a square of background fabric to the outsides of this block. So what I like to do is I'll take my two pieces of outside fabric like so, and what I like to do is I like to flip this over here. And because I know my freezer paper here is the perfect size, I know it's exactly the right measurement, 4 inches by 3 inches, or 4.5 by 3.5, I should say. What I like to do is then take this to the machine and sew using the freezer paper as a guide, so I make sure that this block is going to be exactly the right size. So I'll do that, and then I'll add another one to the other side like so, so that we have our first strip, because basically this block is just a complicated nine patch. So we're going to sew that on now, and then we'll sew on the other half, and we're ready to move on to the next step. There we go. There's part one. So that's the top row of our block, like so. Okay, next step is to repeat this process. So I can take the freezer paper off this here now, like that, and I can reuse this. So I'm going to make this next one here now. So I need fabric 4, which is a green, and fabric 5, which is a blue. So I'm going to take my fabric 4 here, which is this green fabric, and fabric 5, which is my blue, and I'm going to do the exact same process as I did here. So I'll make all of those outside sections, and then I'll come back and show you what it looks like. So there is the outside of the star block finished. So I want you to do that step first, and that'll just get you into the zone of doing the foundation paper piecing. Now, as you can see, I've got the two long strips at either end. So I've added my 3.5 inch square to the outside of the top, and I've added the two 3.5 inch squares on the outside of the bottom as well. And then I've just got the two individual ones on the other sides. Now you'll notice that when you look at the pattern, that these are actually reversed. So here it says it should be blue, and here it says it should be green. But if you flip it upside down, you'll find that it's in the right spot, because when we do this type of foundation paper piecing, everything is reversed. So on the pattern here, it looks like the swirl on the inside is going counterclockwise, but when we're finished, it'll actually be going in a clockwise direction. So I just didn't want you to be confused about that. Okay, so next step is to take the inside piece. Now I've just marked my template with numbers the exact same way I've done on here, but if you want to, you could write down the actual colors so it's a bit less confusing for you. Okay, now first up, I need to add in my center piece because everything on the outside here is going to be worked onto the center piece. So I'm going to take my 2.5 inch background fabric. Let's get rid of these for now. Okay, so I've got my 2.5 inch center square. What I'm gonna do is, as always, flip it upside down, lay my background piece on top. Now you'll be able to see through, I'm not sure if you can see it here on camera, but you should be able to see through to your fabric. And I just want you to make sure that it's centered fairly well. So you're gonna get, when you fold back your fabric, you're gonna have at least 1/4 inch all the way around the outside. Then I just want you to iron it into position just in the center where that octagon is. I think it's an octagon, maybe it's a hexagon. Anyway, so we just want to iron that into place. The next job is to, as always, you've pre-folded your template. So we're just going to fold back every single side of that center. What is it? It's an octagon because there's 8 sides. And we're going to trim off that 1/4 inch all the way around the outside. So there's the first one. I'll fold my fabric back, fold it over again, the next side, and trim. So we've got a perfect 1/4 inch all the way around the outside. Last one. And there we go. Okay, so when I flip it over, you can see here that I've got that perfect octagon on the back there. Okay, so the next step is to start adding these triangles around the outside. Now I want you to notice that you've got some little triangles here on the outsides. Okay, so when I fold those back, you'll notice that that's my octagon shape. Now I'm not going to worry about adding these 4 corners until the very end. So just forget they're even there for now. What we're going to work on is these seams that go across here. They're going to be the first pieces that we add. Now, if I fold that back along the top straight edge, the first seam I need to add is this number 8. So for me, number 8 is my green fabric. So I'm going to take my little triangle or my rectangle here, and that's the piece that I'm going to add first. So I'm going to put it right sides up, fold my fabric back, and look, this is the trickiest part, getting it started. And if I fold that back, you'll be able to see when I fold it under, this is the triangle here. This is fabric 8 that I'm adding. So when I lay that on top, I need to make sure that the fabric extends out here past 1/4 inch. So I need to slide it along, because what I'm sewing is just straight along here. You know how I always say you need to make sure there's enough fabric around the outside to cover it by at least 1/4 inch? Well, the triangle that we're covering is this one here. So that's where we need the fabric to be. So you need it to be just 1/4 inch here to have enough fabric out here. So let's sew that together. So all I've sewn is that across the top of that octagon there. I haven't worried about going out here because that's going to be joined in the next seam. So there we go. As you can see, I don't need to trim up here because I've already got that 1/4 inch there. So I'm just going to fold this back and then I'm going to flip it over, fold back that green fabric and just give it a finger press across the top there. So that's what it should look like. You've got your background fabric here, and you've got your first fabric number 8 sewn across the top there. So I'm just going to give that a good press from the wrong side or the paper side and make sure it sticks to my fabric there. Okay, so there we go. There's the first piece. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to join the next section. I'm going to join is fabric 1, and for me that's going to be my red color. So I'm going to fold this back, trim up my seam allowance here, that can go in the bin, that scrap, and the next thing I need is my red rectangle. So that's my 3 inch by 2 inch, and now what I need to do is lay it across the top, and it'll be a bit easier to fit now, because basically you just want to line it up across the top and sew that seam all the way down. Okay. Okay, so there we go. That's the second seam there. Okay, so we're going to fold that back, flip it over, and once again, we're going to finger press that red fabric nice and flat, so we make sure we get no tucks or pleats underneath here. And then I'm going to flip it over and give it a press from that paper side. Okay, so there we go. So that's what it should look like. That's the front side. So that's our good side. And that's what we've got so far. So next up, we're going to continue in that swirl around. So the next fabric is fabric 2. So I'm going to fold that back once again, trim up my seam allowance. And the next color I need is orange, because that's my fabric 2. So I'm going to once again place that on top, and I'm going to stitch that seam down here. Okay. So once again, I'm going to open up my freezer paper, flip it over, and finger press that orange seam open. And I'll give it a press from the paper side. So this is basically just a procession line. You're just sewing one piece after the other. So we've got fabric 2, which is the orange. Next up is fabric 3. So I'm going to fold that back. And this time we need the yellow. So I'm going to trim up my seam allowance. And notice I haven't trimmed anything from the outside yet. You don't need to worry about that until we've finished all of this swirly business. So I'm going to take my next fabric, lay it on top. And as I mentioned earlier, keeping your fabrics laid out in order makes this much quicker and much easier to stitch together. So there's the next one. Once again, fold it out, flip that over, give it a good finger press, take it to the iron, and iron it down. Okay, so I'm just going to keep going with that process until I finish number 6, and then I'll come back and I'll show you, because this last seam is a bit tricky, so I'll show you that in just a moment. Okay, so this is where I'm up to. I've done my fabrics all the way around the outside. I've just got the one seam left. So if I look at the back here, what I'm up to is I've sewn all the way around the outside from number 8, and I've just sewn on number 6. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold this back, and you'll notice that you've peeled the freezer paper away from these first two. And what I want to do is I want to trim up my seam allowance, but I only want to trim up the last one that I've sewn, which is the purple color for me. So I'm just going to put my add a quarter on, and I'm going to be very careful to just cut through the purple and not cut through the green. We do not want to cut through that. So I'm just going to take that away. And here is my second to last seam, because what I need to do now is add in this yellow. So I only want to sew from the point where the stitching line is of the green and all the way out here. I don't want to go over this seam allowance here. So if I pop my yellow fabric underneath, I want to make sure you can see. So I'm going to line up my top edge like I've done all the way around. I'm going to make sure that there's enough yellow out here for my quarter inch seam allowance out here. I'm just going to sew from here, from that seam allowance, all the way outside. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop that under, and I'm actually just going to wind my needle down to make sure that it goes through that point right there. So lined up with the seam line, I hope you can see there, and I'm going to drop my needle all the way through. And so I'm just going to start stitching from there. There we go. So you can see there, I haven't stitched out here. I've just stitched from there all the way outside. Okay, so once again, I can fold my freezer paper back, flip this over, and fold that back. Okay, so what I need to do now is I need to finish this seam all the way along where the yellow and the green fabrics are. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to peel this freezer paper back, actually I can peel it all the way off. And what I need to do is I just need to undo those first few stitches here where I stitched on the green fabric earlier. So I'm going to grab out my picker and I'm just going to unpick those first few stitches right there, like so. So there they are unpicked here. Okay. So you can see this was the very first seam that we sewed here. So what I'm going to do, I've just unpicked those first few stitches so that I can actually pull that yellow fabric around and to the front like so. See now how the yellow is laying on top of the green. So because we're trying to sew this seam here along through there, that's what we need to do. Now the next thing we need to do to make it possible to stitch that seam is we actually just need to snip into that seam allowance. So I'm just going to take my scissors and as close to the other seam as possible. So I'm going to push my scissors all the way up and under. So can you see where it is there? And just snip once straight through the seam allowance. So you can see I've got a little slit there. And what that's done is it's freed up this seam allowance here, because it's stitched along here, I couldn't move it before. It's freed up that seam allowance so I can actually flip that all the way over and then I can stitch this seam here. So what I want to do is I want to turn it over like so, like that, and continue this stitching line that we'd started all the way out to the edge. So if you want to, you can iron it back onto your freezer paper, but I usually just go by that fold line there from when we pressed it earlier on. So I'm just going to stitch that line, continue it down here, and then I'll show you how to trim it up. Okay, so I'm following this fold line here from when I pressed earlier. And there we go. There's that seam. So all I need to do now is trim that excess seam allowance. So you can use your add a quarter if you like and trim that up. Okay, and then when we press it open, we've got our beautiful swirly. It looks like a little bit of a star itself at the moment. So that's the first part done. So I'm going to give that a press, especially here where that last seam was, like so. Okay, so now what I want to do is I want to iron my freezer paper template back onto this piece so that I can trim it up and add in the corners. So I'm going to flip it over and remember that my number one, my fabric one, is the red. So I can lay that on my seam with number one being the red, like so. And I can press that into position. Like that. Okay, so next what we need to do is we need to trim up the outside of this block. So I'm going to take that to my cutting mat and I'm going to take my add a quarter because we need to add in our seam allowance here. So I'm going to cut all the way around the outside to give myself a perfect square. Now this square should measure 4.5 inches. So you need to keep track. If it's not exactly 4.5 inches, you're going to have trouble putting your block together. So just keep that in mind and maybe check your measurements before you continue on. If it's not 4.5 inches, then I would check your freezer paper template because it's probably the thing that's throwing you off if you can't get your block to line up. Okay, so the final thing I need to do is I need to add in my four corners because they're a different fabric again. So I'm going to fold back this first corner, which is fabric number one. So I'll fold that back and trim up my seam allowance. And I'll do that on all four corners. Okay, so this is what it should look like. Doesn't that look beautiful? So that's our octagon, almost finished. All right, so let's flip it back over to the other side. Now we need fabric number one. So for me, once again, that's my red fabric. Now I'm taking the off cuts from all of the very first squares that we did, and I'm using those off cuts for these corner pieces here. So you shouldn't need to cut any extra pieces. There should be enough left over from your scrap. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lay that across the top, and you can center it. Doesn't really matter where you put it this time, because you'll have plenty of excess fabric around the outsides. And then I'm just going to stitch all the way across that seam. Okay, so once again, I'll open up my freezer paper, flip it over and finger press, then give it a press from the wrong side to stick that freezer paper down. Then all we need to do is trim up the excess seam allowance and continue adding all of the fabrics to the four corners. And there we go, that's the finished center of our block. So now all that we need to do is add in all of the other pieces that we made earlier. So we've got our two sides that go on like so, and then we've got our top and our bottom like that. And there we go. So now it's just like putting together a nine patch. I'll sew these two onto these edges here, and then I'll sew these two onto the edges across the top. So let's flip that one over. Now, once again, I like to leave the freezer paper on the back because I know that that's a perfect 4.5 inch square with the freezer paper on there. Then I'm just going to use that as a guide and stitch all the way down the outside here. And then I'll do the same thing on the opposite side. That way we're going to get really perfect points without having to pin. So there we go. That's the center piece done. Now I just need to add the top and the bottom. Actually, I've got these around the wrong way. I've put that back the wrong way. So see here, we should have the yellows lining up here, and we should have the yellows lining up here. And that's how you know you've got it in the right position. So I'm going to flip that over. Now, the trick here is to make sure when you press these seam allowances, I've actually pressed them the wrong way. I want to press those towards the inside of the block. And you can take your freezer paper out now, and you just want to press the seam allowances to the inside so that when we come to add the next ones, those seam allowances will nest into position. So I'm just going to go and fix that pressing. Okay, so when I take this one over, I can nest those seams. Now this is a case where I will definitely pin because I want to make sure that those line up beautifully. So I'll pop a pin in, and I usually like to pin from backwards like this because that way I make sure the pin doesn't go into the center, into the seam allowance here, and I can leave it in position the whole time. And that way I get a much better seam allowance because I don't have to remove the pins. It's not going to shift on me. And I'll usually put two pins at either end, and I'll have them both there so I make sure that the seam allowance that's underneath doesn't flip back on me when I'm sewing through. So I'll do that there. And I'll repeat that process at the other end, making sure those seam allowances are nested beautifully. And then I'll pop in another pin. And another one here. So now I can take this to the sewing machine and stitch all the way down the outside. Now you just want to make sure that that seam allowance is a scant 1/4 inch to make sure that you keep your points on the inside of the block. And there we are, that's our finished block. So this block should measure 10.5 inches, and you should see that you've got a good 1/4 inch on the outsides where those points are, so that when you join them together you don't lose those points. So we need to make a total of 6 of these for the finished quilt. So you just once again reuse your templates, your freezer paper templates. You only need to make one of the center, and you should, I usually make 4 of the outside piece so that I can put together one whole block without removing the freezer paper. Now a few of you might be a bit worried about where we snipped into the seam. Now because we've stitched across here, that seam is fine. It's perfectly fine. It's going to be nice and secure because there's not going to be any pressure on that seam allowance. And once we come in and do the quilting, we're going to quilt over the top of that, and I promise it will be perfectly fine. So make 6 of these, join them into the row, and you're done for this fortnight. Pop them up on your design wall, take a picture and share it on the Slow and Steady Quilt Along Facebook page. Thanks for joining me. I'll see you next fortnight.